So we are dealing with the example of partial balancing method, where we are dealing with the reaction between metal and nitric acid. So if any metal is made to react with nitric acid, this reaction will always take place in two steps. First step, second step. Now in the first step, the metal will react with nitric acid to produce metal nitrate and nascent hydrogen would be formed, for sure. In the second step, the nitric acid will react with nascent hydrogen formed in step number 1 to form oxide of nitrogen and water. So these are the two steps on the basis of which the reaction partial balancing method for reaction between metal and nitric acid is balanced. Suppose if a question is given to us, this question goes, balance the following reaction or the following equation using partial balancing method. A reaction is given to us, an equation is given, and that equation need to be balanced. Suppose this equation is, the equation which is given to us is zinc react with nitric acid. Zinc react with nitric acid to produce zinc nitrate, N2O, which is termed as nitrous oxide, and water. This is the skeletal reaction need to be balanced using the partial balancing method. So what we'll do, we'll follow two steps. In the first step, the metal is made to react with nitric acid to produce the metal nitrate and nascent hydrogen. First step is, so I said, ki division of the step is based on the nature or requirement of the product. So what we need in the product? So we need zinc nitrate as one product, nitrous oxide as the second product, and water as the third product. So depending upon the requirement of the product, we choose or divide the steps which are termed as the partial steps. Now, in the first step, zinc will react with nitric acid to give zinc nitrate. Since complete NO3 would be used, therefore only nascent hydrogen would be left. So this is one step called as the first step, where only one of the product is formed. Only one of the product, that is zinc nitrate. And leftover is nascent hydrogen. Now, in order to produce the other two reactant, we need one more step. Now, in this second step, we need to produce nitrous oxide and water, in this N2O and H2O, we need only nitrogen, hydrogen and oxygen, but we don't need the metal zinc over here. Therefore, in the second step, I'm not taking zinc. So in the second step, this HNO3 is made to react with hydrogen to produce the nitrous oxide and water. So what we said, that the skeletal reaction is divided into two or more steps depending upon the nature of the product. These are termed as the partial step. Then I said, these partial steps are then need to be balanced. These partial steps need to be balanced. So first step is being balanced. Second step is being balanced. So what happens? In the first step, one atom of zinc react with two molecule of nitric acid to produce one molecule of zinc nitrate and two nascent hydrogen. In the second step, in order to produce nitrous oxide and water, we are reacting this nitric acid with nascent hydrogen. Now again, balance it. Now nitrogen on this side is 2, N2O, just to balance it, we are putting 2 over here. It was HNO3 reacting with nascent hydrogen to form N2O, H2O, and now we are balancing the second step. So N on the product side is 2, N on the reactant side is 1 in HNO3. Just to balance it, we have put 2. So 2HNO3 giving N2O and H2O. If it is only H2O, then look on to the number of oxygen. If it is only H2O, then look on to number of oxygen. So nitrogen on this side is 2, nitrogen on this side is 2, oxygen on this side is 2 into 3, 6, whereas oxygen on this side would be 1 in case of nitrous oxide and 1 in case of water, where there should be 3 into 2, 6 oxygen. So to balance the oxygen, just to balance oxygen, we are putting 5 in the front of water, so that the oxygen becomes same, that is oxygen get balanced. So after putting 5, it becomes, so it is 2HNO3 giving N2O and 5H2O. So N on this side 2, N on this side 2 balance, O on this side 3 into 2 6, 1 and 5 6 balance. Problem is with hydrogen. Hydrogen on this side 5 into 2 10, when there is only 2 hydrogen in 2HNO3. 2 hydrogen in 2HNO3. So in order to balance hydrogen, we are putting 8 nascent hydrogen. So how second step would be balanced? So the balanced second step would be 2HNO3 plus 8 hydrogen giving 1 N2O nitrous oxide and 5H2O. So first step balance, yes, it is Zn plus 2HNO3 giving Zn NO3 whole twice, and 2 nascent hydrogen is produced. In the second step, 2HNO3 react with 8 nascent hydrogen to produce N2O plus 5H2O. So what we have done? We have divided the skeletal reaction into 2 steps. This skeletal reaction is divided into 2Y2. It is depending upon the product. We need ZnNO3 whole twice zinc nitrate as one product, nitrous oxide and water as the other product. So depending upon the need of the product, we have divided the skeletal reaction into 2 parts. That is 2 steps. And first step, second step, we have balanced the first step, we have balanced the second step. Now I told you, the chemical reaction is first broken into 2 or more step, termed as partial step, depending upon the need of the product. Then these, in the second step, the partial steps are then balanced. The partial steps are then balanced. So we have broken this skeletal reaction into 2 step, called as the partial step. These steps are individually balanced. And now the third part, we have to cross balance it. Why cross balancing? In the first step, only 2 nascent hydrogen are produced, whereas in the second step, 8 nascent hydrogen are used. In the first step, 2 nascent hydrogen are produced. In the second step, 8 are being used. So in order to balance this nascent hydrogen, we are multiplying step 1 by 4. Just to make this 2 hydrogen 8, we are multiplying step 1 by 4. So only step 1 is being multiplied by 4. And on balance, on multiplication, the partial equation, the equation becomes, so what we have done? The first step is been multiplied by 4, whereas second step is kept same. So after multiplication, it becomes, first step is now been multiplied by 4. So it becomes 4Zn zinc 1 multiplied by 4. So 4Zn, 4 into 2, 8 HNO3 gives 4 ZnNO3 whole twice, 2 into 4, 8 nascent hydrogen. The entire step is been multiplied by 4. After multiplication, this is it. The second step is written the same way. The second step is written the same way. No multiplication, not needed. So I have written 2 HNO3 plus 8 nascent hydrogen giving N2O plus 5 H2O. The first step is been multiplied by 4, but second step is written the same way. So what we have done? The skeletal reaction was broken into two parts, termed as the partial step. These steps were then balanced individually. Since it is needed, it is cross-balanced. That is, first step is multiplied by 4. After cross-balancing, these are the two cross-balanced steps. And finally, we are equating the cross-balanced step to get the final balanced equation. So if I equate these two steps are equated, so it becomes 8 nascent hydrogen produced, 8 nascent hydrogen used, so it get cancelled. It is on the product side, this is on the reactant side, cancelled. The other product is not getting cancelled. So the final equation becomes 4 Zn, 8 and 2, 10 HNO3, 8 and 2, 10 HNO3 giving 4Zn plus 10 HNO3 is giving 4ZnNO3 whole twice, 4ZnNO3 whole twice plus a molecule of N2O nitrous oxide and 5 molecule of water. So the balanced equation is, so this was the skeletal reaction. Skeletal reaction was Zn plus HNO3 giving ZnNO3 whole twice plus N2O plus H2O. Now the balanced form of this equation based on the partial balancing method is 4Zn plus 10 HNO3 giving 4ZnNO3 whole twice plus N2O plus 5 H2O. This is the balanced chemical equation.